Our first reading today is a grim warning to modern-day world powers who bully their neighbors. It is a very good reminder for nations that have become economically prosperous and militarily powerful to the point of throwing their weight around, refusing to follow international laws, and behaving with arrogance and impunity like entitled pre-modern colonial masters, blatantly disrespecting the sovereignty of smaller nations. You know, you can reread the same oracle of doom and judgment pronounced by Isaiah in our first reading against the kingdom of Assyria. And this was written 2,800 years ago. You can replace the name of Assyria with the names of modern-day imperialist nations, and the message will remain just as fresh as if it was meant exactly for them. They should be reminded of that famous saying that goes, "Those who forget history are condemned to repeat it." In those times, it was the Assyrians, Babylonians, Persians, Egyptians who lorded it over the ancient Near East. They had their own versions of megalomaniac rulers who behaved like the later Alexander the Great, who established the Hellenistic Empire that was eventually replaced by the Roman Empire. And then came the Byzantines and the Ottomans. But ask this question, nasaan na sila ngayon? Where are they now? Even the kings, the monarchs of Spain and Portugal once divided the world between the two of them, between themselves, and of course, among other Europeans, there were also the Dutch, the British, the French, and the Italians, who followed suit and enjoyed the benefits of plundering their colonies in Latin America, in Africa, and in Asia. Europe had its later share of leaders like Napoleon, Adolf Hitler, Mussolini, and Franco. Where are they now? What has become of them? And who was it? Who was it that said that it was a manifest destiny of their mighty nation to expand their borders and to occupy new territories? Kung nag-aral kayo ng Philippine history, you remember that. Manifest destiny. And what is happening now to their great nation? And so I suggest that you reread the oracle of the prophet Isaiah at mag-fill in the blanks kayo. Palitan yung name ng Assyria at ang ipalit nyo ay ang mga modern world powers. Sabi ni Isaiah, "Woe to you, blank." O, kayo nang mag-fill in the blanks. "Woe to you, my rod in anger, my staff in wrath. Against an impious nation, I sent him to seize plunder, to carry off loot, and to tread them down like the mud of the streets. For, he says, by my own power, I have done this, and by my own wisdom, because I am shrewd. I have moved the boundaries of peoples, and their treasures I have plundered." And then the prophet says, pwede bang magmalaki ang palakol sa humahawak sa kanya? Can the axe boast against the hand that holds it? Will the saw exalt itself above him who wields it? As if a rod could sway him who lifts it. Therefore the Lord God of hosts, will make these fat ones starve. Gagawa daw ang Panginoon ng hakbang na yung mga bansang sobra ng yaman at taba ay magugutom. And instead of his glory, there will be kindling like the kindling of fire. Nakakapangilabot. In the gospel today, Jesus is pronouncing the same prophetic words, praising his Father. Sabi niya, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, but you have revealed them to the little ones, to the children. Alam niyo, the same prophet Isaiah once made a proclamation, another oracle of hope. Sabi niya, darating ang panahon, isang maliit na bata, a little child will be anointed by God, and he will be called Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. Long before we made the icon of the Santo Niño, the infant Messiah, Isaiah the prophet already proclaimed an oracle of hope about a child who will be entrusted with power and dominion, but he will put an end to war and conflict and violence. Isaiah spoke about the time when the child will play by the viper's den and will lay his hand on the adder's lair. Sa lungga ng ulupong, ipapasok ng bata ang kamay niya at hindi siya masasaktan. That this child will invite the nations to the mountain of the Lord to seek wisdom and instruction so that they will learn to beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks, so that no nation shall ever again raise the sword against another, nor shall they train for battle or for war ever again.